Hello everyone, welcome to e-lecture series initiated by LJ Institute of Pharmacy. Myself Dr. Dilip Maheshwari, working as a professor and head of department QA and chemistry at LJ Institute of Pharmacy. In today's session, we will discuss about affinity chromatography. Affinity chromatography is basically liquid chromatography method in which the compound is separated out on the basis of the which type of ligands are used, and they can interact with the substance and they can be separate out your compounds on the affinity towards the ligands. It is a well equipped liquid chromatography techniques which can be used well defined binding agent as a stationary phase for the purification of sample component. It is a chromatography method which is used for the separating biochemical mixture based on a highly specific biological interaction such as between antigen and antibody, enzyme and substrate, or receptor and ligands. Here there are four types of affinity chromatography which is based on the which type of molecules are used as a ligands. Number one, bioaffinity chromatography, where biological molecule used as a ligands, example lactins. Immunoaffinity chromatography, ligand which are used as a antibody or its related reagent. Diligand affinity chromatography, di like a tetrazine or triphenyl methane is used as a immobilized ligands. Fourth one is immobilized metal ion affinity chromatography. Here the different type of metal are used as a ligands, so it is known as immobilized metal ion affinity chromatography. There are four type of affinity chromatography which are based on the which type of material are used as a stationary phase. Now the mechanism or theory of affinity chromatography. Here in this chromatography, material which you want to isolate, which you want to purify, they can be selectively attached to the immobilized ligands. Immobilized ligand is nothing but your stationary phase. To the unreactive material do not attach to the ligand and pass through the column. This ligand, this stationary phase is a very specific targeted group is available in their structure. So what happen, they can be attract, they can be attached directly your compound which you want to isolate, and the remaining compound, the remaining impurity, they can be drained out through the column. So you see the complex formed by the attachment of the material to the ligand remains stable until disrupted by the introduction of dissociating agents. Once this complex is formed, they cannot be detached unless and until you are using some dissociating agents, so you get the very purified compounds. So here when you introduce the displacement agent, there are many type of solvent are used, like a buffer are used, potassium thiocyanate are used as a displacement agents. When you change the pH of the environment of your complex, so they can be easily detach your compound from the immobilized ligands and you get the very purified compound at the bottom of the columns. So this is the mechanism or principle of separation of affinity chromatography. See, this is the schematic diagram of affinity chromatography. You see, in first step, the matrix plus ligands, they make a some environment in the columns in the stationary phase. Then in second step, when you applying the sample components, so what happen, the proteins impurity which are present in the mixture, they can be passed through the this matrix and they can be make a complex with the your proteins and your ligands, and remaining impurity they can be eluted out. In third step, the displacement agents or elution buffer they are using here, and from that your compound pure proteins they can be isolated, they can be extracted out at the bottom of the columns. So this is a schematic diagram of affinity chromatography. These are the some example of ligands and counter ligands which are used in affinity chromatography. When you are using antibody, so antigen, virus cell, they can be separated. Enzymes, substrate analog or cofactor are used. Lactins, polysaccharide or glucoproteins, cells are used. Nucleic acid, hormones, vitamin, receptor, carrier protein, non-antibody binding proteins are separated out. Sugars, lactin enzyme or sugar binding proteins. So these are the ligands and counter ligands which are used in affinity chromatography for the separation of biological substance. Here, advantage of affinity chromatography for the separation of protein and RNA. Basically, this affinity chromatography are useful for the separation and purification of protein substance, biological substance, RNA and DNA, antigen and antibodies. Here, the main advantage, it increases the purity by 1000-fold, the number of purification steps reduce, the species is very concentrated, you get at the end, stabilized on the binding, suitable for the large-scale purification process. This type of chromatography is used. These are the main advantage of this chromatography. Now, steps or methodology or components of affinity chromatography. The first step is selection of good affinity ligands. Second step is preparation and evaluation of affinity adsorbent. Third step is immobilization technique. Fourth step is dissociation of material. So here, first step, selection of good affinity ligands. The totally separation and purification of this chromatography is depend on the which type of affinity ligands you are used. They should be a very specific, they should be a very targeted to your compound which you want to isolate. So you have to select properly. So here there are two types of affinity ligands are available. Number one, monospecific affinity ligand. And number two, group-specific affinity ligands. Monospecific affinity ligands are used, they having a capacity to specific compounds for the making a complex with the specific compounds. And group-specific ligands, here the similar structural compound, similar chemical characteristic of compound, similar physical characteristic of compound, they are there. So they can be make a complex with the group specific ligands. So at that times group specific ligands are used. So you have to select according to the chemical characteristic as well as physical characteristic of your compounds. So they can be easily bind with that and they make a complex. Once your complex is made, so then the 80% of your compound are go for the separations, the 80% of process is over. So you have to select the good affinity ligands. Second one step is preparation and evaluation of affinity adsorbent. Here in this you have to, after selection of ligands, you have to prepare in the proper solvent. Here the agarose are used, different type of gel are used, then cephalodex are used, polyacrylamide material are used, the glass beads are also be used for the stationary phase in affinity chromatography. So for that you have to prepare in the proper solvent. Sometimes soft gel you are using, they having enhanced, they can be swell on the 1000-fold than the original physical volume. So you have to prepare in proper solvent and then introduce into the columns, so you get the proper results. So that is the preparation and evaluation of affinity adsorbent. Third one is immobilization technique. Immobilization technique means here the stationary phase or ligands which are used, they have to reactive with the your compounds, because your mixture contain the less amount, very small amount of your compounds, the other impurities are more, because you are going for the separation, you are going for the purification of biological compounds, they contain the other impurities. The proteins having a long chain of structures, and they also contain the different type of impurity in that when they are present in the biological sample. So for that you have to prepare your ligands which are more active. They can be directly specific, make a complex with your compounds, and you pass the solutions which can be give the unreactive other chemicals, chemical bond which are present in the ligands. So that is the immobilization technique. The fourth step is dissociation of material. So once the complex made between your sample and the ligands, then the other impurities and other process is over. Now you have to replace your compound from the complex. So for that, generally the different type of buffer are used. You have to change the pH of the environment between the complex of ligands and your substance, so they can be easily removed out. Generally potassium thiocyanate are used as a displacement agents to remove your compound from the complex, and you get the very purified compounds. So these are the four steps of affinity chromatography. Now towards the applications here, affinity chromatography is used for the nucleic acid purifications, protein purification from the cell free extracts, antibody purification from the blood serum, purification of recombinant proteins. Affinity purification is used to purify the initial GST fusion protein to remove the undesirable anti-GST antibodies from the serum and purify the target antibodies. So basically this chromatography is used for the biological substance separations, their isolations and their purification of antibody, antigen, proteins, DNA and RNA. So this is about the affinity chromatography. Here affinity chromatography is a very important technique. It is a liquid chromatography technique for useful of biological substance separation of and purification of biological substance. Thank you very much for listening this video. Please subscribe PharmaIgnite channel by bell icons. Thank you.